My name is Lucille Javier Templo Nuevo.
Oh, Walde Templo Nuevo.
One I see. V is very, very.
TEMPLONUEVO.
We meet here in Houston when he come from the ship because he's a nautical engineer.
I was in the Merchant Marine before.
Uh-huh.
I am a third officer in the Merchant Marine.
Uh-huh.
And we dock in the port of Houston. And there is a group of Filipino from the church. They are having some fundraising.
And I am the assigned PRO. So part of our way of entertaining our visitors is giving them a party.
And from there, I saw my wife over there is selling some Filipino products.
Oh, I can't remember. I can't remember because that way back in 70s. Because we got married in 74. Or no?
Oh, that was way back in 1973, I believe. Yeah.
No. 76, 77, I can't remember. 74, maybe 74 because I come in America in 72. Through the party.
Okay.
I introduced myself and she introduced herself to me. And from there, we do some talking, joking, and from there we started some something better. So every time I duck in every port, I just send her some kind of souvenirs. And she responded that every time I send some postcard or any gift, coming from different countries, and she appreciated that.
Me, because I'm the PRO of the association.
I made it first move.
Hello, welcome to the FAMH party, and honoring you people from the ship.
I know that at that time, it's time for me to look for a permanent girlfriend, whatever you call that. But actually it is, I'm shopping for a wife. So.
As far as I remember, hey, hi, ho, you know.
Well, first of all, I introduce her that I am a single man. I'm about ready to settle down. So I told her that if I could be your husband, I will really accept that one. But it's up to you if you really like me. So I leave it up to her. Well, actually, she didn't say at that time. She didn't say nothing, but she just she smiled and. I follow it up, sending a love letter to her. I say that I really like your the way you act and your attitude at that time when I meet you and your background at all. But that was in mid 73s. When our boat was in Baton Rouge, we are loading some cargoes going into Montreal, Canada. The captain said that we will be staying for another 2 weeks, so I had the time to see her personally and her residence. So I took a bus going into Houston, Texas, and from there she invited me to her apartment.
I will say there is no date at all.
She gave me a dinner. She prepared me a dinner with the candlelights and all. Then we talk a little bit, jokes and everything. Then we watched a movie after eating.
I did not give him. He gave me, I think, a watch. Okay. A camera.
Or a watch.
A watch, yeah.
I gave her a Citizen watch, which I bought that from Japan. Uh-huh. Yokohama, Japan. She is the one asked for it. She said she likes a Citizen watch, and it's hard to find in Houston, Texas.
Actually, I'm an old-fashioned woman. I do not entertain things, kissing or something like that. He just say hi. Can we be friends? I said, why not?
Well, actually, the first kiss is in her residence when we were eating at the same time as the first day, yeah.
We are not very romantic in so many ways.
I told her, if you take me as your husband, I will take care of you. Whatever happens to me or to you, we will take care of each other. And I know you will not regret if you will take me as your husband. Actually, at that time, I didn't get any answer at all.
Before we go back home, he passed by and he said, are you ready? I said, okay, I'm ready. What do you want and where do you want? I said, I want it in Manila. And I don't know the charge yet.
When we are in United Kingdom, this is in England, and I received that letter and he said, I can't remember what is in the letter, but at the very bottom he said, love mommy. And the first one is dear daddy. So I assumed that I got a yes at that time. My father and my mom did not have any complaint or anything, because first of all, I'm at the right age already to get married. Secondly, I have a permanent job.
Because he is from that part of the country, that's the Bicol. That is, you know, all saying that they are tamad, they are not lazy, they are not so much like that. But I told him that this guy is educated and I have the background. I have the analysis that I requested somebody in Manila. So they said, okay, if you want it.
She is fine. She said she is fine. She is a very respectful woman, and I think it could be trusted as your wife to be. She is a jealous woman. So the favorite color that she always wear is yellow and green.
I don't know. Maybe a blue.
She looks better. Actually, that's the reason why I get her to be wife.
I'm older than he is, but since I have been exposed to a different venue in my life, I feel like I look better than him.
Yeah, she was good looking at that time. At the time when she was young.
The most annoying thing that he does is recently when he asked me $2,000 for gambling.
When she bugged me too much. And that's one thing I don't like. Keep on bugging, and that's the one I cannot handle it. Why did you not do that right? So I said, okay, what do you want?
Him. Yes, him.
It depends on where. If just going a short trip, I'm faster than her. But if I'm going somewhere like in the parties, I have to prepare my self, look better and dress up better. So I would say I'm a little longer than her.
The same time I'm dressed up, I'll go to the car and wait for 10 minutes. And he's going around getting his hat, getting his shoes, you know. He got that adobo and the ginatan in Bicol, that is the gabi.
Well, she only, the only thing that she cook is like vegetables, is pinakbit or whatever you call that in here. And some spaghetti, she could take care of his spaghetti.
He won the bowling very recently, got the trophy.
Well, she only goes on bowling if I'm in the league. Yeah, once in a while we go in the bowling. Yeah, she was with me on the league one time. So far that's it. And, well, also there's a time that we go fishing. We consider that as a hobby. She like crabbing and fishing.
The way I analyze it, he just don't want me to get tense. I have not observed anything.
She's very in heights. Because I remember we went to Dallas at that time, Six Flags, and we wrote, you were small, my two kids are small at that time, and she could not even look at the ground when we were right on top of that building, right? Well, after the marriage, we went to Baguio City, which is the summer capital of the Philippines. And what we call this is, what do you call that after marriage you go for what? For vacation or something? What do you call that? What's the terminology that I can forget?
Hawaii. Because the scenery, the entertainment that Chris gave us, it's a very wonderful time.
Honeymoon, yeah, that's it.
When he say he's ready, and I said, let me think about it, and then finally I said, okay, but the only time I can is in the 70s, 74, I think, that's where. And then he told me, okay, I will go back to Manila and prepare everything.
I saw some good things that I'm looking for from a wife, or to be a wife. The way she act, and the way she talk, and the way she treat the people. From there, she opened my mind that I think this is the right woman that I'm looking for.
We'll make it through, and I hope you are the one I share my life with. I don't